We are honored to be guests of Eddy Grant, music star who invited us to visit his homeland in Guyana, in Amazonia. Anai is an area close to Brazilian border and now based on this trip. In today's show, Eddy Grant and I are supposed to catch and land a couple of piranhas on the Rupununi River. Is it possible? Stay with us till the end of this episode. First, we have to fly to Barbados, where Eddy is living today.
Hi, I'm Eddy Grant, the new host of the Fishing World show. Why? Because I can't find Radomir. He must be by the pool or something. Let's go see if I can find him. Because I don't know anything about fishing, and I want him to join me on a trip to Guyana.
The carnival is all for you. So here is what we're all gonna do.
Hey, Radomir, come on, wake up, man.
Come on.
We gotta go to Guyana to do Fishing World.
Oh, fishing, finally. Let's go.
Okay.
Yes, we met with the music legend Eddy Grant in Barbados and we flew to his country of birth, Guyana. We visited Bagnara Resort, the capital city of Guyana, Georgetown, famous K-Turf waterfalls, and finally we are in the central west part of Guyana on the Rupununi River. Before we explore fishing, I think that we unexpectedly have a companion on this trip. Is he a guy from India? He sounds like he's an Indian from maybe Brahmaputra or Ganges River. Guess who he is.
So Radomir, you have come to the wrong place to catch fish. I ask you to come to West India. You come to West Indies. It's the wrong place, man. You are going to catch no fish here. I promise you, my friend, you should have gone to Ganges.
Fisherman leaves Guyana shore.
Which way is it, Brazil?
Show me the way to India, man. I want to get to India. Wonderful, wonderful. This is nice. We are going right direction now.
Okay, now let's go fishing on Rupununi River. Let's explore wilderness of the real Guyana. Fish is becoming nervous waiting to be caught by two professionals like Eddy and I. But also, several caimans are waiting to get some easy lunch. Seriously, caimans are a real threat in these waters. Several months ago, one 8-year-old boy from nearby village was attacked while cleaning a fish on the river bank and was unfortunately eaten by a few meters long caiman. Later, local villagers found the killer caiman, and when opened his stomach, they found the boy's remains. Caimans and piranhas are serious danger in these waters, but we never think about it while fishing, always when we return home, always late. When we came to fish on the Rupununi River, the water level was very, very low, and our boat was hardly running upstream to the fishing spot. There was a real danger that we could get stuck on the sand and stay in the middle of the river until someone finds us to rescue, the same day, or maybe not. There is no mobile phones coverage on this part of Guyana. There is no electricity, roads, computers, just mosquitoes and animals, especially caimans. Guided by an experienced captain and his buddies, we were gliding to desired spot. Commonly, we go fishing by boat. But
we can go fishing by car, by bicycle, by roller skates, by horse, by motorbike, but we can go fishing with airplane. Hey, here's Nikki, our new friend.
Nikki, hi.
Nikki and her brother own the company, who has so a lot of experience in flying
in Guyana.
Yes.
How many planes do we have?
We have 7 aircraft, 4 of which are a type like this, which is called a Cessna Grand Caravan. And we have 3 Britain Norman Islanders, which is a smaller aircraft to this than this.
And you started your businesses in the beginning of 90.
Yeah, we were involved in gold and diamond mining. My grandfather was a pork knocker in Guyana, which is the guys that pan for gold. And he also supplied food supplies into the mining communities in the various parts of Guyana.
What kind of mining?
Primarily gold. Mostly gold and diamond mining.
Mm. How many tons of gold you can carry? And diamonds.
Well, in weight it's heavy, but the aircraft obviously has limited load. But yeah.
Okay. How many fish you can carry?
That.
All
now is a different question.
All fish I can.
If you as many as you can catch, we can fill.
Tourism became very important for the economy of Guyana, so you're carrying tourists more and more.
Yeah, well, Guyana is such a vast, beautiful country that's very untouched, and I think that with the current global environment that we have, you have this beautiful, pristine environment that I think the world should like to see. You
nice.
Know, yeah, we have beautiful savannas. We have the rainforest, it's pristine and untouched. And, you know, when you come in here, you feel like you're the first person to have arrived. It's so beautiful.
Yeah, that's it. That's it. That's a fish. I got it. Oh boy. Oh boy, let me see.
Woo! Big boy!
Oh boy. It's a big one.
This
I think
is a big
here, here is a colony of piranhas. Where I should put this one? Eddie, move your legs.
Back.
No, move your legs.
I'll be a one-legged guitarist. Woo!
Ah.
Let's see him.
Okay, this is a big boy. This is a big boy.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. It's nice piranha. Frank, I must tell you, you won't tease me
anymore.
This evening.
King of the piranhas.
Yeah, this is nice piranha. It has I should say it has it has
5 or 6 pounds.
3 pounds.
No, 5 or 6 pounds.
Sorry?
It's about 5 or 6 pounds.
5, 6 pounds?
Yeah.
Okay, you said it.
That's right.
All right. So I need the pliers. I need all precautions because this boy.
Oh, you need a new hand.
And for such big boys, I need something very special.
That's right. Wow.
Wow. This is a nice piranha. Oh, we have a catfish. Hey. Oh, look at the whiskers.
Yeah.
I wish I could have such whiskers.
Oh, yeah. The girls would be loving it.
Yeah.
A few words about Rupununi River. It is located close to Brazilian border, and nearest town to the river is Anai, which has small airport where we landed. we met an interesting person in Anai. He's British. He left UK many years ago to build his home here in Guyana, far away from any civilization, but also from city traffic, dirty and crowded streets, far from what we call urban life. Do we always get what we want?
I came to Guyana 20 years ago and found the Rupununu savannas rather like this. It has taken me some time to develop what you will see to my right. Welcome to my world. Welcome, viewers of Fishing World. What you see behind me is the big rock of Rockview, from which the Rockview Ranch and now Rockview Ecotourism Resort has been named after. But scattered around, you'll see smaller rocks, which we have used to create an environment which is appropriate to the rock and the surroundings. The result of using these rocks in the construction, in the design, in the landscaping of Rockview is to create a harmonious blend between nature and man's desire to create a comfortable, beautiful, aesthetic, eco-friendly lodge for visitors. So you will see rock blending with burnt brick made right here, with wood extracted from the forest, and the plants in and around these buildings. People quite often ask me why it is that I'm so happy here. But the truth is that I have no interest anymore in traveling. I have so many wonderful things to do here, visitors to receive, gardening, landscaping, creating. At a certain point in one's life, one realizes that life does not need to be complicated. It can be beautiful in its simplicity.
It is a time to return to Rupununi River, to return to our fishing with Eddy Grant. Do we have enough fish to make a show, or we still stay with empty hands? It is our last day on a trip to Guyana, and we are a bit excited if we will make our attractive fishing show still.
Now you got a big boy. Eddy caught big piranha.
Oh, Jesus! God. Welcome to Fishing World. Welcome to Guyana. Welcome to Piranhaville. I'm glad you didn't get me, brother. We come in town,
singing a song. Oh, no.
Ah, my man.
Yeah, we must take a picture. You and Piranha.
I can tell you.
From now on, I'll call you Eddy Piranha.
The Piranha.
The Piranha.
Well, I never thought I'd meet you today.
It was a pleasure meeting you.
It was really a pleasure meeting you.
You want a kiss?
No. I think we should throw him back.
Well, no. Don't throw
him back?
Just hold. Boop, boop, boop. Do you hear that sound? Boop, 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 boop. Boop. That means
he's not happy.
Eddie, I'm not happy.
He's not happy.
I feel like celebrating now. Who is nicer?
Take off your glasses, we see it.
Who is nicer? Now it has
piranha.
6 pounds. Yeah, I guess it is like 5-6 pounds. And now becoming bigger. Like balloon.
Yes.
Who's nicer? What lovely eyes.
Lovely eyes he's got, man.
So Eddie, how was feeling?
How I was feeling?
Yeah.
Like I caught a big fish.
What is the score?
3-1.
3-1. Yeah, each one caught a fish. Oh boy, this is another one.
It's caught another one.
That's another one. So, Hendrix is the winner.
Yay! Guyana, 3. Serbia, 2.
Closer
to the
camera,
so it would
look much bigger.
Ah.
Yeah.
Thank you for joining the club.
That's all right.
Yeah.
Big boy.
Yeah.
Yeah,
your one can eat mine.
I tell you something, both of them can eat both of us.
It was a lovely day fishing here in the Guyana on the
Rupununi River.
Rupununi River.
Yeah.
See you next time.
Yeah.
In Guyana.
Alright.
Welcome to Guyana.
I dream I was in Africa, and I was a warrior, hunting lion and tiger, brave like my forefather. Something wrong when I got to sing this sad song.
One day the village fell in grief. It was the death of the tribal chief. Now the chief had a son named Motuba, who was to take over. Then came another warrior who claimed to be the next ruler. They tested each other in battle, and Motuba was the conqueror. Oh, oh, oh.
Hey, Radomir, come on, man. Stop dreaming about fishing. Come on, you got a job to be done here. You got to clean the swimming pool.
Why? It's clean.
I think you left some waste in there.
Ah, that's fishy lures. Eddie, what do you think? If I start singing, maybe I can bring some fish.
I think you better stick with the porn. The porn has got promises.
We love you. We love you.